All right, what is more problematic, being stuck in space or being stuck in a bad marriage? Our next guest perhaps can answer that question. We know him from so many projects, including HBO's Avenue 5. Here comes Kyle Bornheimer. Kyle, good morning to you.
Hi, how are you, Sam?
Really good. Nice to speak to you. You are in every show that matters. to come to kind of a screeching halt so abruptly a few months ago, how did that feel?
That's a great way of putting it. It did feel that way. And it's hard. You know, I mean, of all the arts and crafts, acting is one you kind of got to be out there and do. And it's hard to, you know, obviously we've all stopped. And we're all, you know, this entire cast and all my friends and other shows and at all levels, we're kind of pining to get back out there. I just noticed there was like an online play that someone had put together, and I was like chomping at the bit, like, is there a part for me? I'd love to just do something. I'd like to pretend to be someone else for a little bit.
Kyle, let me ask you this, and I've not posed this to anybody, but I feel close enough to you that I can ask. Is there ever a fear of getting rusty? Do you know what I mean?
Sure. No, sure. And it's weird. You know, actors don't have, it's funny. My son is getting into and loves boxing. And I pulled up some YouTube videos yesterday. We did some boxing training together. And I'm always looking for that with acting when you're kind of stuck and you can't really do what you normally do and you're not in the environment, is looking for like exercises, you know. So all it is hard sometimes alone to kind of find something to keep you in shape. Because yeah, I've thought about that several times. Like, have I forgotten how to act? There's, you know, auditions here and there with voiceover stuff, but it's not enough to kind of keep you in the shape you want to be. So I've been like designing little games and, you know, basically talking to myself a lot, which my family is always calling me out on. Like, dad's out in the backyard talking to himself again.
With Avenue 5, Jessica St. Clair plays your wife, and they keep pairing you with her in a variety. This is the third show you guys have been on together?
I think we've even done four now, and we've played different incarnations. I mean, we've been brother-in-law and sister-in-law. We've been boyfriend, girlfriend. I was her rabbi in her show, Playing House, that she created with Lennon Parham. And we're good friends. We love working with each other. This opportunity to work with Armando Iannucci, who created this show, and his style of a combination of scripted and improvising was just heaven for us. We knew we were going to have a lot of fun playing off each other in this one.
Speaking of scripted and improvised, I imagine Brooklyn Nine-Nine, this is just all in my head, that you do one the way it's written and then 20 however you guys feel like it. Yeah, you play the quote-unquote bubbling police chief there. What about that show?
Well, Teddy's great. You know, I get a cue. You know, Teddy is often described as the most boring man in the world. And you know, a lot of people around me like to think that it's based on me. And I bring a lot of my own blandness to Teddy. And yes, you're right. There's a, you know, that show moves fast. I mean, a lot of these shows are getting so good at this in terms of their timing that it is like, you know, two or three takes sometimes. And everyone's so good on that show. They've been doing it for so long. That yes, but it's more around the edges. It's not often, you know, you're not often like, hey, you know, one for me, and then you go off on a 20-minute improvised rant. But you play around the edges a little bit, and certainly some actors on that show love to do it more than others, and everyone loves to roll with it. It's part of the fun. I mean, it's part of, you know, you love reading other people's material and doing it like that, and it's like such a celebration of the hard work, the craft of the writing, and then also improvising.
All right, Kyle, we appreciate it very, very much, keeping us laughing on Avenue 5 and Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Kyle there, Frank and Jess, over to you.